lean on, like, the lips. Yeah. In, like, hotels, you'll have brands.
I've always just wondered, how they get to find it, like, on the wall.
I guess, do they have someone with them?
Come on in. Let's welcome Jacob Tremblay, Noah Jupe, and Bryce Gheisar. Come on down. Stack up too much.
Kids who bully usually don't mean to hurt people as much as they do, and
it's just good to show what actually happens in the middle school.
RJ Blasco did an amazing job on the book, and I read the book when I was preparing for the role, and I just thought it was amazing. My mom obviously cried, and I tried to hold in tears. Moms.
I think it's really cool, yeah. I mean, seeing good people's eyes, the Wonder Fair today, I think it's a good way to be able to see through other people's eyes if you don't have anyone who has a disability in their school, to be able to see their differences so that, you know what their story is.
If you like being the boss, you can be a director. And that's as many things you can pursue in that. Just do what you want to do at the end of it.
You should just try whatever you want to do, and always trying something is the best way to find out if you want to do it. So, you should always be open to learning of other people, and never be like, no, they're wrong. Always open your mind to every possible advice you can get, because, you know, it may make you a better actor or whatever you want to do. And as Jacob said, and Nike said, just do it.
My guess, and maybe each one of you talking to pursue your careers, has not been an easy thing. You might love it, but it's not easy. Is that accurate?
Yes, there are some challenges. Some roles can be harder than others, like crying scenes. And the Wonder I do crying scene. It's very emotional and draining. But I love acting so much because I just love to become a new character. I just think it's so interesting, and I just love to be able to go on set and really just like go on stage and really see action just perform. I think it's just awesome. I want to do it for the rest of my life, because I've had the time of my life. And yeah, there will be challenges along your career, but just know that there will be challenges with any career, and you just have to be strong, I guess.
How do you like get your voice?
Say that again.
How do you like do the voice? Like,
oh, the accent?
Yeah.
The American accent?
Yeah.
Well, actually, it's kind of easy, I have to say. Because in England, you know, I love movies, and I watch many of them. Most of them, to me, people have American accents, and especially the Disney movies, all of them have American accents, and you know, so it was kind of easy to get in and to get into the accent. But then, you know, you had a coach there for my first few jobs doing it, who helped me tweak the tiniest bits that weren't quite right or something that sounded English that I needed to change. But yeah, it just takes time and work. Bringing it back to working for, you know, what you like. Yes, I can. I can kind of go into it. And it's easier in America because it's kind of like I'm around a lot of people. Like, I've been talking to these two all day with American accent. So, I guess, is that okay?
Can you do a Boston accent?
I don't think so. I don't want to try because I don't want to embarrass myself.
It's hard. You get noticed everywhere, much like yourself.
Not needing to be rude and not needing to really hurt the other person. So they don't really realize how they're affecting people. And like, whenever Julian goes to his grandma's house, he really realizes everything that he did that was wrong and feels super bad about it. And he really wants to apologize to Augie. So that just shows that there are really two sides to every single story, so.
Jacob, what is your favorite scene that you acted out in the movie? Probably the cafeteria. You know, that was really fun to do because most of it was actually like improv, so I think that was pretty fun.
I did a lot of
that. He did a lot of people that day. It was like all over his face. Yeah, that was a classic.
until you have too much of it, and then I don't like it.
What do you want these guys' message to be from that movie, from your work? What do you think it is, or what do you want them to know as fifth graders, hopefully spreading a culture of kindness, I guess?
I'm going to go for quite a different thing than, you know, choose kindness, because I'm going to leave that for one of them. But I'd say, you know, don't be scared with your friendships. Don't be scared to go and ask someone to hang out or have lunch with, just sit down and talk to. Because, you know, in your groups and you have your best friends, sometimes it's a bit, you know, strange to think about that being different. So that's probably what I would say. Just don't be scared to talk to people and get to know them.
That's pretty awesome.
Give me thumbs up.